Welcome back. I am super excited today to introduce you to the new second edition of our book, Data-Driven Science and Engineering, by myself and Nathan Kutz. This truly is a labor of love. This is a subject both Nathan and I are super passionate about, and we really put a lot of ourselves into the second edition, so we're super happy with it, and I hope you get a ton of benefit out of the things we added to this. So I'm just gonna walk you through kind of what the motivation for this book is, what the philosophy is, and what's new in the second edition, so you can decide if this is something you want to read yourself. And chances are very good. I will put a link in the description to a PDF of this book so you can read it, usually for free. Stay tuned for that down below. Okay, so this is the second edition of a book that Nathan and I wrote a number of years ago. So the first version of this book, I think, came out in 2019. We had been working on it for about 4 or 5 years before that. I'm a professor in mechanical engineering with adjunct appointments in applied math, aerospace engineering, and computer science and engineering. Nathan Kutz is a professor with dual appointments in applied math and electrical engineering. And the first edition of our book, Data-Driven Science and Engineering, was really very much focused on teaching emerging technologies and machine learning and data-driven methods to engineers. Okay, so not just computer scientists, but real engineers, you know, aerospace engineers, mechanical engineers, electrical engineers, and so on and so forth, who have deep domain knowledge and physics knowledge. We wanted to give them the tools in machine learning, dynamical systems, and control theory that are kind of driving the field forward. And similarly, we wanted to give methods people who are, you know, maybe in computer science or applied math, developing these new techniques in data-intensive methods, we wanted to give them, you know, some insight into how their methods could be really applied in physical systems, in engineering systems. So kind of two big audiences trying to tie it together here in this book. But the field changes so rapidly, even in the last 3 years, things changed so much, we needed to put out a second edition. And I'll tell you about what the features are in a minute. So kind of the philosophy that I take in this whole world of, you know, how do I bring machine learning into engineering is the following. So behind these boxes, there's a bunch of cool fluid flows. That's one of my passions in engineering is fluid modeling and flow control, because it's so applicable to nearly every trillion-dollar industry, whether it's defense, healthcare, transportation, energy, you name it. You know, modeling and controlling fluids is going to help us do that better. And machine learning is helping us model and control fluids better. It's helping with us with almost all engineering tasks. So at the end of the day, the philosophy I like to take, and we definitely take this in the book, is that there are some fundamental engineering tasks, regardless of what your discipline is, things like modeling, design, optimization, sensor placement, estimation, and feedback control. This is just a small list of many of the engineering tasks we have. And at the end of the day, almost all of these tasks end up being really hard optimization problems. They're hard because the physics is nonlinear and multi-scale, usually in space and time, which leads to high-dimensional non-convex optimization problems. And so one of the key ideas is that machine learning is this process of building models from data. We have an increasing wealth of data. We have better optimization algorithms. And so we can build models from data with optimization. That's what machine learning is. And we can start solving some of these engineering tasks with these machine learning models and with these emerging machine learning optimization techniques. If you think about training a neural network, that's a high-dimensional non-convex optimization problem. Maybe we can use those same techniques when we try to learn good sensor placement or some feedback control law for a nonlinear problem. So these technologies go really naturally together. Engineering tasks are increasingly solvable with machine learning models and data-driven optimizations. That's a perspective. And to some extent, the reason this is true is because patterns exist in your data. So even, you know, very complex systems, very high-dimensional systems, whether it's, you know, a network of neurons in your brain, a disease ripping across a continent, or a very complex geospatial fluid flow, patterns exist in your data. You can compress that data, you can extract key features, and you can use those with these data-intensive methods for modeling, estimation, prediction, and control. And so our book starts off with how do you extract these patterns from data? And then how do you use those patterns for modeling, for decision making, for control, for things like that? So we're very much focused on this idea of how do you extract low dimensional patterns and features from high dimensional data? And then how do you use that in an engineering context for dynamical systems and control? Okay, good. So I want to talk through kind of what are the actual things we've added to this. We've added a ton. This is a very major overhaul in the second edition. It's not just that we went from blue to pink. For example, new to the second edition, we have new chapters, two entirely new chapters, one on reinforcement learning, and one on physics informed machine learning. These are two extremely exciting and rapidly developing fields that we thought were, you know, first off, they fit the theme of the book very, very well. They're at this intersection of engineering and machine learning. And so these are two really, really exciting new chapters that we have added. We have moved from having just MATLAB code in the first version. Now every single code is in MATLAB and Python. We have Python codes for every single example in the entire book. And if you go, I think in our on our website, we also have some codes in Julia, R, and C++ in various stages of deployment. But we have full code in Python and MATLAB. In my videos, I notice viewers want Python at least 3:1, so this was a huge overhaul for us. We have videos for every single section. Every section of the book, every chapter, every section, there is a video either by myself or by Nathan on one of our two YouTube channels. So if there is something you are reading about and you're a little confused, go check it out on YouTube and maybe it'll make more sense when we explain it to you in person. Okay. Again, something we're passionate about is making these things have lots of different ways you can learn. You can read about them. You can try to code them up yourself. You can hear us kind of give you a more classic style lecture like this on our lightboard. We have new sections throughout the entire book. So in addition to these new chapters, most of the existing chapters have new sections that dive deeper into material we may have missed or overlooked in the first edition. So for example, in our chapter on Fourier analysis, we added a new section on the Laplace transform, super important for control theory and dynamics. We overhauled the neural network section, entirely because that field is moving so quickly. Same with the data-driven dynamical system. So lots of new sections throughout. And we also have homework for every single chapter. So extensive homework that was not there in the first edition of the book. Now we have homework for, again, every chapter of this, ranging from kind of easy to medium to research level projects. So you can use this for classes if you want and really get some inspiration for how, not just to codify the material and to, learn by doing, but also to really get started on some research level challenges in some of the advanced homeworks. So, these are the main ones. We found a bunch of typos. Nathan and I are far from perfect. There were a lot of typos in the first edition. It's much, much cleaner in the second edition. So these are kind of some of the big things we've changed. And I hope you like them. I hope you find, these new chapters to be really, really useful. I hope you find the Python code. Maybe many of you, were asking for this. I hope this is really useful and you can actually use these techniques more, because of this code. And again, this is a link, databook.pdf. This is a link, I think this is currently a link to the first edition of the book, but we're going to update this. So, hopefully by the time you watch this, this links to the second edition PDF of the book. So you can go check this out for yourself. If you like a paper copy, great, buy it. If you want to use this and have a searchable version, by all means, please do. And again, we have this website, databookuw.com, where we, we have each chapter broken up into the videos. So you can go to our YouTube or you can come here to databookuw.com. It has links to all of the code, all the data sets, all the different languages, all the videos. This is a pretty useful resource. I find myself going here pretty often. Dynamics Lab on GitHub. This is our kind of group GitHub repository between my group and Nathan Kutz's group. And so we have lots and lots of repos here. You'll notice Databook Python and Databook MATLAB. That is a living repository of all of the codes for every chapter of the book. So if you want to figure out how to make a robust PCA algorithm in Python, go here and go to chapter 3 and download that code, and it's there for you without much searching. And similarly, this is my YouTube channel. Nathan has a great YouTube channel also, where you know all of the sections in the book, again, are here. This is me presumably showing you the phase portrait for a double well system. But again, this is our lightboard setup, where every single video, every single section really is illustrated, you know, hopefully in a way that helps you understand the material. Okay, so that's the mile-high summary of the new features in this book. I'm so excited. You know, we really, really were passionate about making this. We loved the first version. We saw a lot of potential to make the second version even better. And so I hope you like it too. Let us know in the comments if there's things you want in the third edition, if there's things that, you know, we did in the second edition that you really did like, or, you know, maybe made it harder for you or easier. So do let us know. All right, thank you.